This is a bloke who, whether he's going to the basketball or the opera, always has had the best seats. What do you think is going to dawn on him when he's 10 rows back from what he could have been, which is in the front row and part of all of this as part of the ceremony?
Well, he blames it onto everybody else. He blames the fact that he's back there in the 10th row because he's spare, and therefore the head, the title of his book was correct and all that's in it is correct because he's always had the bad hand. One of the things he grumbled about was that William had 5 sausages and he was only allowed 4 when he was quite a young boy. And it, you know, he's remembered that all these years to moan about. So he'd say he's been put in row 10 because, you know, that people don't care about him. I don't think... He thinks that, what have I done to be put here? Let's try and make amends. I mean, he's just asking for everybody to apologise to him privately, individually. But it would take months because he's got hundreds of complaints about how they behave. But he's got nothing, not one, that is that his fault.
And Sarah Ferguson has been quite realistic here that she's been divorced from Andrew for an incredibly long time. She had no expectation of being invited. She's not being invited. But she's trying to, again, remind people that at the heart of all of this, there is a family occasion, and that's a good thing.
Yes. I mean, it was very interesting what she said. They divorced in 1996, I think. But what she said was she was on a TV program and you knew the presenters wanted to say how angry she was and how unfair it was. But she said, look, I'm divorced. This is a state affair, not a family affair. And it's quite right. You can't have it both ways. And that's the thing that people have tried to say to Harry and Meghan. You can't have one foot in the royal family and the other foot using it to make lots of money. And she said that, which was a dig. And she also said the important thing is to bring the family together. Families must come together. I'm very close to King Charles now, and particularly Camilla, and they invited me for Christmas. You know, she hadn't been there for 30 years because Prince Philip wouldn't allow her anywhere near where they had Christmas. So the first time for 30 years, she was invited. She said she had a lovely time. She feels very close. And I think the dig again was, you know, get together. We are one family. And apparently, I don't know this for certain, but I've been told that Eugenie, her daughter, who is very friendly with Harry, the relationship has cooled down. And I think that that's because of what Fergie has said. But there she is. She tries to put people together. She tries to be kind. She's obviously very eccentric, but she feels like all of us feel that this is a time when the family come together. This is King Charles's moment, and you can't keep thinking of me, me, me.
Camilla's son, Tom Parker Bowles, has had a bit to say of recent times, including this nonsense that Harry put out there, which was that, you know, Camilla was all part of a giant plot to eventually become the queen. She wasn't just going to be the other woman. She wanted to, you know, get Diana out of the way, and this was all part of her evil, inevitable plan. That's, of course, total garbage. But as a person who has written quite a spectacular book about Camilla, what do you think about her son speaking out about, well, the elephant in the room so close to the coronation?
I thought it was brilliant of him, actually. He doesn't talk about his mother very much, even though he's a chef and writes books on food and recipes. But I think that he just couldn't bear it. And he said it very gently. He said, people said to him, what do you think now? Your mother's a queen. He said, I don't think of her as a queen. She's my mother. She's always been my mother. And that's how I see her. But, you know, she said that she married King Charles because she was in love with him. And she's loved him, you know, since they met. And that it's nothing to do with what plan she had. She hasn't tried to work out a way where she would get married and then become a queen. It's just not her. She has not done that. And I thought that was a very nice way of telling Harry that he didn't know what he was talking about. Obviously, Queen Camilla couldn't say that, and nobody else within the royal family could. But there he was, absolutely standing, you know, saying what he wanted about his mother. I thought it was very touching. And he's the sort of person who wouldn't have done it unless he really wanted to. And I think that's the way you can get at other people, because obviously he knows his mother much better than Harry does. And he's always loved her. And he's always loved King Charles, who is his godfather. And he thinks he's a great man. And he's not full of venom and hatred and all that. I thought he gave Harry a nice little smack.
Bloody oath. Well, you always give us a nice hug from the other side of the world. Enjoy the next little while. We'll talk to you soon. Thank you, Angela.
Thank you.